that we may gain a heart of what? Wisdom. Do you know what it means? He said, teach me to number my days. It means the wisdom you used yesterday is not the wisdom you are going to use today. That's why he said, teach me to number my days. Because every human being, as you are, God has created the day you are going to die. God has days for everyone. And every of your day, God has put a wisdom that you are going to use. So we're going to say, Father, let the Holy Ghost, let the Spirit of yours begin to direct us to the wisdom of every day that we need to do. Look, let me tell you, you need to drop your pride when you want God to be. Say, Father, it's not longer me, it's no longer me, but let your Spirit begin to lead me by your wisdom. Every day, things I need to do, things I need to say, things I need to do. Father, we need your help, we need your help. My Holy Ghost says, teach me to open my days so that I will apply my heart with wisdom, so that I will apply my heart with wisdom. I may apply my family with wisdom. I may teach my children. I will apply my marriage with wisdom. I will apply my business with wisdom. I will run a ministry with wisdom. I will talk to people with wisdom. I will communicate with people with wisdom. I will address my destiny, my career, my future, my education with wisdom. Whatever I do, that's your wisdom to take place. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. The last scripture, 2 Corinthians, that Pastor Nick preached for. This is the last prayer point. This is very important. This is very important. Before we read that scripture, I had a call 2 days ago. Thank you, Lord. I need to say this. I had a call 2 days ago from a lady. And she called me. She hit a number. She called me. She said, I like what you people are doing. And I saw you people online. And the Spirit of the Lord told me specifically to ring you. And I said, she said, Spirit of the Lord told me to ring you. And I said, what is the problem? She said, I've been divorced for many years. But the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me to call you that I know that God can restore my marriage. Amen. He said, the Spirit of the Lord, I said, say it again. She said, she hid her number. She hid her number. And I said, it doesn't matter. I don't want to know your identity. He said, and I said, where is your husband? I said, my husband is not remarried. My husband is here, but I know. And the Spirit of the Lord told me, and God begins to point hand at me. Before, I used to see him. Everything he does is him, I see. I see he's wrong, but now God was telling me I should look inside myself. So now, I'm beginning to look inside myself, and I'm seeing all his good parts. I no longer see his way, but I begin to see even my own wrong, but I didn't see it for many years. This is where the scripture comes. Every time you begin to look up to someone, you will not see where God needs you to change. And let me tell you, life is a corporation. Even in, I told her, I said, what you are doing now, this is what God wants you to do. And even your husband will need to do something. Because even as you are doing, he will need to do. Because if you are trying and he's not trying, what happens is that it's one way. So no matter what it is, no matter the argument, no matter the struggle, but both ways need to begin to try to make it work. Because the just shall do what? Live by faith. And sometimes you say we live by faith, but when this happens, Pastor, I'm not the scripture. They say, when there is a situation, that's why you don't really know what is inside of you. The Bible says, when you faint in the days of trouble, that means your strength is weak. So that means you have not been strong before, but you're always saying you're strong. But the day of trouble, when you begin to show actions and begin to allow your actions to control you instead of you to look inside that, it means that you are weak. It just reveals you. But you know what? Even in our weakness, God can make us strong. That's why I said, so, please keep it as 2 Corinthians. That's what we want to read. And that's what we need to look inward. The scripture says, look inward. Don't look the next verse. Look what?
Inward.
Is you. What did he say? Say, me.
Me.
Tell yourself, say, me.
Me.
2 Corinthians 5:15. This is very important. As we are speaking, we might be speaking to you that you are out there. We want you to hear. Look inward you. Look inward you. And I told her, I said, God can restore. It doesn't matter, God can restore. And when God restores to you, he will even restore it and even make it fresher. But God has already answered the prayer, but it's left for us. Do we want to do what he's telling us to do? Or we want our self-pride to decide our actions. Because we can allow the situations to tell us how we want to do things. But we can allow the Spirit of God also to tell us. Jesus lived, he showed us an example, and it's him we look up to. He humbled himself and loved the way Pastor Nick ended with Philippians. He says, he, even though he was God, but he did not, he was equal to God, but he did not. He humbled himself all the way to the cross. He opened not his mouth. He looked to himself, he didn't look to others. He could have said, oh, this one, are you not the one who fought me? You will see today. I will show you that I'm Christ. No, that's not the way. It doesn't matter what happened. Things can happen. You can flee right now. Things can happen. When it happens, get back to track. That's what God wants. But if you refuse to get back to track, it means that you know what you refuse to agree. So it says, watch this, 2 Corinthians 5:15. It says, and he died for all, that those who live, should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and rose again. So who do we live for? We live for Christ. Let's just lift up our heads and say, Father, we are speaking to the whole world today. And even this moment, I believe that God is restoring things. Even you watching online right now, God is restoring things right now. Even your relationship in your workplace, God is restoring it. The relationship with your friends, God is restoring it. The relationship with your family members, home, marriages, relationships, God is restoring it right now. If you look into yourself like the man who was lame, who was blind for 38 years, he looked to himself and said, nobody was able to push me. Jesus says, no, it's not the problem, it's not with me. The problem is with you. Do you want to get up? Do you want to get up? The problem is not who to push you. The problem is not with the angels. The problem is with you. I have made already the solution. Do you want to get up? Father, we are getting out of this. 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 We look inward for us. We look inward for us. The issue of blaming them, he, she, we rebuke that spirit. And we begin to walk practically. We begin to make it right. And if we refuse to make it right, Father, let your spirit begin to rebuke us. We make it right, Lord. Help us by your spirit. Paul said, the life that I live is no longer my life. I live it in faith in the Son of God who gave himself for me. Father, the life that we live is no longer our life. We live it in faith in you, Jesus Christ, because you died for us. You died for us. I was so dirty. I was so pure. I was so unclean. I was so unholy. But you washed my sins away. You died for me on the cross and took all my shame. I refuse to see others. I see only you.